one would be electronic systems and technologies too. This involves concepts of amplitude modulation. So I am engineer Randy Oliado from Morph Cebu. Okay, these are our subtopics ngayong araw na to. We have AM parameters, we'll be discussing the modulation index, trapezoidal patterns, transmitted power, voltage and current. Then we'll be dealing with single sideband modulation, the AM power saving. Then we have modulators and demodulators. Then lastly, we'll be talking about the receivers. Okay, so let's begin by defining what is modulation. Now, para madaling maintindihan yung modulation, I would recommend that we'll represent this with the word change. So, for example, pag sinabi mong amplitude modulation, so that would be amplitude change. Pag sinabi mong frequency modulation, that would be frequency change, or phase modulation, phase change. Now, even though this is not really the meaning of modulation, but this could help us analyze kung ano ba talaga yung uri ng modulation yan. So basically, modulation is a process. No? So it's a process of having a baseband. Alam na natin yung baseband. We have talked about that last time. Such as the voice, the data, the video, the data. No? Baseband yung hindi pa, kung baka raw pa. No? Modify another high frequency signal known as the carrier. No? So that basically is the module. So basically, if we'll relate it with our previous discussion, modulation now is makukonsider natin na broadband type of transmission na. So in our discussion also last time, we know that there are three parameters of a sine wave that could be changed. No? We have the amplitude, we have the phase, and we also have the frequency. That's why we have three basic types of modulation also. No? We have AM, FM, at saka PM. So I have here a simple illustration of a transmitter and how modulation could take place. So this, we could input here your information, and here we could input your carrier. So the amplifier will amplify the signals, and once ma-mix na silang dalawa dito through nonlinear mixing in our previous discussion also, it could produce the sum and difference at the same time. Depending kung anong uring modulation yung gugustuhin mo, yung information will change the parameter of your carrier na nandito. No? So for example, if amplitude yung type of modulation, if this is AM, then it will change the amplitude of the carrier. If this is FM, it will change the frequency of the carrier. And if this is PM, it will change the phase of the carrier. So kumbaga, nag-mix tayo ng dalawang signal, and kung ano man yung uri ng modulator natin, siya yung lalabas dito na uri ng wave, like an AM wave, an FM wave, or a PM wave. But always remember na yung information natin is mas mababang frequency kumpara sa ating carrier. So yung modulation is a process in which yung information mo, such as the video, voice, and data, will change something at the carrier. No? And si frequency na information is mas mababa kaysa frequency ni carrier. So once mangyari na yung modulation, i-amplify natin, and it could be now be radiated through space. So that's basically is the concept of modulation. Now, why there is a need? Why do you think is modulation needed? No? Why there is a need for modulation? Now, there are several reasons, and some of the reasons are stated here. No? So pinakauna, it will make your antenna size becomes becoming into a practical size. No? So for example, yung pinaka-common natin na information is the voice, which basically from 300 to 3000 Hertz. So based on ating discussion last time, we know that lambda is equal to C over F, and yung antenna natin is cut through the size of your wavelength, no? Depende sa wavelength. Yung, kung let's say gagawa tayo ng maikli lang, then we will use a lambda over 4 na antenna. So getting the wavelength of halimbawa lang, no? 3000 Hertz. Yan yung may pinakamaliit na, na wavelength, pinakamataas na frequency yan. No? So that would be 3 times 10 to the 8 meters per second. Divide natin sa 3000. So that gives us, calculate natin, 3 exponent 8 divided by 3 exponent 3. So that gives you how much is that? 100,000 wavelength, no? 100,000 meters or 100 kilometers. So, i-divide natin ng 4 para makagawa tayo ng antenna. So, that would be 25,000. Ha? Yung lambda over 4 na is 25,000 meters or 25 kilometers. So, can you imagine if you have a 25,000 kilometer antenna? So, that is impractical. So, by placing this information into a high-frequency carrier, such as, let's say, 10 megahertz carrier. So, what is the wavelength of 10 megahertz? So, wavelength of 10 megahertz is solved natin, 3 exponent 8 divided by 10 exponent 6. So, that gives me 30 meters. So, if I will get lambda over 4 out of my 30 meters, so divided by 4, so that gives me a length of my antenna na 7.5 meters. And that would be practical kumpara sa 25 kilometers. Diba? So, that is one way. No? We can actually make antennas more practical in size. Then obviously, kahit anong nationality naman tayo, no? Kahit nga dito sa Pilipinas, iba't iba yung dialects natin, kahit na Ilonggo, Bisaya, or di kaya Chabacano, Tagalog, we all speak with the same frequency, no? 300 to 3,000 Hz. So if we will not modulate and we will transmit all of these voice signals into space, then that would be mag-aagawa ng space sa 300 to 3,000, and that would be makongest siya ng madali, and that would be very prone to interference. So whereas pag nag-modulate tayo, iba-iba kasi yung carrier na pipiliin, so hindi mag-interfere yung information even though the information has the same set of frequencies, 300 to 3,000. So it's like in AM, the information is 300 to 3,000 but the carriers are in kilohertz. In FM, it still has 300 to 3,000 but the carrier is in megahertz. So dun pa lang, alam natin na hindi na magbabanggaan yung dalawang information na yun because they have different frequencies ng kanila mga carriers. So that is one way to avoid interference. So pangalawa, obviously, is to make the information range longer. So if we'll only rely with our voice, that basically is short distance, 10 meters, 20 meters. But if we'll use radio waves, so it could go beyond pa nga a country, no? It could cross the oceans, it could cross the Great Lands, and it could even reach the sky, no? In outer space, halimbawa for satellite comms, no? So that could really expand the range of our communication. And obviously, for modulation, it could be possible na yung isang fiber optic mo na cable could run different information, or isang coaxial cable mo could carry different information because nga iba-iba yung frequencies na nagdadala ng iba't ibang information and they will not interfere with each other. So in data comms, modulation is napaka-significant because nga in data comms, multiplexing is also very common na ginagawa. So these are the reasons, no? Some of the reasons, not all the reasons, but some of the obvious reasons why there is a need for modulation. So our topic ngayon are basically analog lang, no? So nahati kasi yung modulation sa dalawa, no? Analog at saka digital. So siguro mga later part of isat natin, we'll be dealing with the digital and data comms na, no? So for now, today we are discussing amplitude modulation. By our next meeting, we will be dealing with the angle modulation naman, the FM and the PM. So itong mga FSK, PSK, QAM, mga pulse amplitude, pulse position, pulse width, so that will be reserved for digital modulation na soon. So ngayon, we'll be specific muna sa analog, and specifically, we will be having AM. Okay, so let's talk about amplitude modulation. So sabi ko nga, yung modulation can be changed into a word that change para hindi masyadong mahirap. So pwede natin i-crash out yan and palitan natin ng word na change. So pag sinabi pa lang amplitude modulation, it is amplitude change of the carrier. And saan nakadepende yung change na yun, we will talk about that. So AM or amplitude modulation. So the information signal, like the baseband signal, varies the amplitude of the carrier. So it changes the amplitude of the carrier. So the information changes the amplitude of the carrier. But what part of the information nakadepende yung pagbabago sa amplitude ni carrier? So actually, sa amplitude din information. So see, the instantaneous value of the carrier amplitude, so yung carrier amplitude known as the VC, is nagbabago in accordance with the amplitude din ng inyong modulating signal. Now, if this modulating signal is new to you, this basically is na-discuss natin last time, no? This is also the baseband signal or the information. So, nakadepende yung pagbabago sa amplitude ng carrier sa amplitude din ng inyong modulating signal or information. So, in short, if walang pagbabago yung inyong information ng bultahe, then wala ding pagbabago sa amplitude ng inyong career. Kung magbabago na yung amplitude ng inyong information, then magbabago na rin yung amplitude ng inyong career. So that basically is the process of amplitude modulation. Now before we proceed to how this really works, let's specify muna the difference of the information and the career. So the information obviously is the low frequency, such as the voice, no? So the 300 to 3000, no? That would be the information. Low frequency dapat yung information mo, no? Low frequency signal to be delivered to the destination. This obviously can be also referred to as the intelligence, the modulating signal, or the baseband signal, no? So yun yung mga ibang tawag natin sa information, but most of the times mga libro, ito yung ginagamit talaga to refer to this information, the modulating signal, or yung signal na magpapabago dun sa ating career, no? So in which yung carrier naman is yung mas mataas na frequency, no? So the high frequency signal used to carry the information na, no? So used to carry the information from the source to destination. So siya yung high frequency at siya yung magdadala ng information. So you can think of this as si information is ikaw, and if you want to go to great places or far places, pwede ka naman maglakad, di ba? But why will you walk if pwede ka naman sumakay, no? So if sasakay ka, obviously you choose a vehicle that is faster than you, no? So and that would be your career, no? So pwede kang sumakay ng bus, sumakay ng jeep, sumakay ng train, sumakay ng eroplano, sumakay ng barko, no? So those could be referred as careers ng transportation. So dito naman sa ating information, pwede silang pipili ng career. As obviously, as long as high frequency sila, no? So pwede sila sa kilohertz, pwede sila sa megahertz, o pwede sila sa gigahertz. So those are some of the carriers ng modulation natin, no? So that's basically, no? Napakasimple lang, no? If the information is the modulating signal, then obviously yung carrier is the signal to be modulated or the signal to be changed, di ba? So si carrier yung signal na babaguhin mo, or the signal to be modulated, whereas yung magpapabago sa carrier is the information or the modulating signal. So napakadali lang talaga, no? So because alam na natin yung dalawang yan, now let's talk about this basic amplitude modulation concept, no? So we must learn in this discussion na to, what's the modulating signal, what's the signal to be modulated, what's the modulated signal, and ano yung tinatawag natin na envelope. Okay, so let's begin with the modulating. The modulating signal obviously is the information. So ito na yung information natin. Because nga most of the information is voice and mahina lang yung power ng voice, then there is an amplifier here so that lalaki na yung voice amplitude natin. Now in a mixer, there are always two na frequencies na papasok natin, si FM at saka si FC. So si FM is the modulating signal and si FC is si carrier frequency. So ito na yung si carrier. So makikita mo, this is low frequency and this is high frequency. Now, after amplification, lalaki na yung signal natin, and we could expect na yung information natin nagbabago yung amplitude niya, so the carrier will also change its amplitude. If bababa ito, then bababa din yung amplitude ni carrier. So if this mixing will happen na with amplitude modulation, then it would look like this. So as you can see, habang nagbabago yung amplitude ng information natin, hindi na constant yung amplitude ng ating carrier, but nagbabago din siya. So lumaki din yung amplitude ng ating carrier nang lumaki yung amplitude ng ating modulating signal, and lumiit yung amplitude ng ating carrier nang lumiit yung amplitude ng ating modulating signal. And if you happen to notice, mapapansin mo na if titingnan natin yung mga peaks, and we will connect the peaks of this modulated signal, it actually resembles the shape of your information. So itong imaginary line na ginuguhit natin dito is ito yung tinatawag natin na envelope. So ibig sabihin, si modulating signal is si information. So masasabi natin na si modulating signal is itong information na to. Then si signal to be modulated is yung carrier na to. Diba? And si modulated signal is the change signal, yung nabago na, no? So ibig sabihin ito na yung modulated signal. And obviously, itong envelope nito is the imaginary line that resembles your information. So ito na ngayon yung envelope natin. So once nandyan na yung modulated signal, i-amplify na lang natin and ready na yan for transmission. So that basically is napakasimpleng amplitude modulation. So, basta isipin lang natin na sa amplitude modulation, kung magbabago na yung amplitude ng ating modulating signal, that's the time also na magbabago na yung amplitude ng ating carrier. If walang pagbabago sa ating modulating signal, then expect walang pagbabago sa amplitude ng ating carrier. So that's the basic concept ng amplitude modulation. Now let's move on to the equation ng amplitude modulation. So this is the instantaneous voltage of amplitude modulation, and this is its equation. Now, para mas maintindihan yung equation na to, kasi maraming mga problems din na bigyan kailan ng equation, and you need to answer kung ano yung mga tinatanong na parameters. So we need to familiarize how this what are the data contained in this equation. So we can divide this into three. So meron tayong tatlong terms dito, 1, 2, and 3. So this first term actually is for the carrier, no? So that is the equation, the term that talks about the parameters of the carrier. Then yung pangalawa, yung may plus, makikita mo plus dyan, pero may minus dito, cosine minus, no? So FC minus FM, obviously that is the lower side band. So yung plus na yan, image minus dito, that would tell us the lower side band term or parameters. Yung minus has a plus here, no? FC plus FM, that would give me the upper sideband. So ito na ngayon yung upper sideband ko, no? So makikita natin na itong VC na to, actually this maximum voltage of your carrier, no? So the peak voltage of your carrier. This one is the peak voltage of your sideband. So that would be lower sideband peak voltage, and this would be the upper sideband peak voltage, in which makikita mo it still is a function of the carrier voltage. Now, hindi pa natin na-discuss yung modulation index, but sinabi na dito that the modulation index is Vm over Vc. We will discuss this later. But just in case, we will assume that M is equal to 1, and M is equal to 1, makikita natin sa equation na to na yung pinakamalaki palang voltage sa sideband is kalahati lang ng carrier, no? Vc over 2. Pinakamalaking voltage sa sideband, either upper or lower, is actually Vc over 2 lang talaga, no? So, because nga yung allowable na maximum modulation index or yung M is equal to 1 lang. No? So, obviously, if this would be lesser na modulation index, then the peak amplitude of your sideband will not reach the VC over 2. So, in short, the VC over 2 na value is maximum na yun. But it could be lesser than that. No? And it should not be greater than that, because nga yung ating modulation index maximum value should only be equal to 1. So that's basically the parameters here, no? And itong part na to is the angle, no? So kung bubuuhin natin yan, it's actually equal to omega t, in which yung omega t is equal to 2 pi f t. So ito na yung 2 pi, ito na yung t, and ito na yung frequency mo, the fc minus fm. So para mas maintindihan pa natin lalo yan, meron tayong hinanda dito na equation galing sa inyo, or example, galing sa inyong larva exam sa kukontest natin. And marami itong tanong na to, so that will be starting at number 10 dun. So with that, sasagutin natin to. So the equation is provided, and let's find the VC. Walang problema yung VC, no? Because this is the carrier, ito yung minus, so that would be the upper sideband, ito yung plus, this would be the lower sideband. And you can see it naman, no? Mas malaki yung value na to kumpara sa value niya, so that would be the upper sideband, and this would be the lower sideband, and this would be the carrier. So wala nang problema sa mga voltage, no? Voltage C, voltage upper, voltage lower, automatic. So this is the voltage ng carrier, 4.75. Ayan, tama na, no? The voltage ng upper sideband, 1.78. So ayan, 1.78. Voltage ng lower sideband, 1.78. So that is napaka-bonus ipalabas sa board exam. Kung voltage na yung pag-uusapan. Now how about these frequencies na to, yung tatlong frequencies na yan. So para mas makita nyo, let's draw it, no? The spectrum of your AM. So let's assume that the center line is the carrier, and the upper line is the upper sideband, and the lower line would be the lower sideband. So we know that the upper sideband is FC plus FM, and this is FC minus FM, and this is just FC. So dito sa angle na to, makikita yung data for the frequency, no? So pwede natin sabihin na yung part na yan is actually equal to 2 pi ft, di ba? So that would be your omega, no? Omega t or 2 pi ft, which is sa carrier equal siya kay 1090 times 10, let's just make it kilo na lang, no? Para mabilis, no? 1090 kilohertz, kilo na lang talaga, no? So kilo pi t. So, meron tayong pi. So, cancel natin yan. Meron tayong t. Cancel natin yan. So, this gives me 2f is equal to 1,090 kilo. So, I can now solve for my f. F is 1,090 kilo divided by 2. So, getting your get your calculator and you solve it. 1,090 exponent 3 divided by 2. That should be my frequency in hertz, which is equal to 545 kilohertz. And that would now be the answer. That is now my FC 545. So, madali lang, ah. So, halimbawa, yung upper sideband frequency. So, ganun pa rin. Equate pa rin natin. We know that that is omega t or 2 pi f t. So, this is now your frequency ng upper sideband. So, upper sideband. Mamaya na lang natin ilagay yan. No? So, that would be equal to 1, kuptahin na natin yung angle na yan, buong angle na yan, 115 kilo pi t. Diba? So, 115 kilo pi t. So, cancel yung pi and t. Pi and t. So, that gives me 2f equal to 1115 kilo. So, therefore, my f is equal to 1115 kilo divided by 2, which gives me, so 1115 exponent 3 divided by 2, that would be 5557.5 kilo. 555 lang pala, no? 557.5 kilohertz. So, this is now my upper sideband. So, for my lower sideband, eh, tama naman, no? So, for my lower sideband, you can do the same, no? So, that would be 2 pi ft is equal to 1,065 kilo pi t. So, cancel, 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 cancel. So, that gives me a value which is equal to 1,065 kilo divided by 2 or over 2. So, 1,065 kilo. Tapos, divide natin ng 2. So, that gives us 532.5 kilohertz. So, that now becomes my frequency na lower sideband. So, yun na yun. No? Upper sideband natin is 557. So, this is now 557.5 kilo. And this would be 532.5 kilo. And our carrier is 545 kilohertz. So, okay na yan. No? Nasolve natin yung tatlo. Pero what if yung tanong is the FM? So, ano ba yung FM? Now, we know that the upper sideband is 557.5. The FC is 545 kilo. So, definitely, we can solve for FM. So, same goes on the other side. We know that the FLSB is 532.5 and the FC is 545. So, you can pick whatever you want. No? So, pwede natin piliin yung 557 if you want because nga, from this point to this point, that would be your information or that would be your FM. Kasi, so, yung FM pala natin, is yung distance na to distance na yan. Kasi nga FC plus FM becomes the upper sideband. FC minus FM becomes the lower sideband. So this distance na to na frequency mo would refer to your modulating signal frequency. So it cannot be seen directly on the equation, but you can solve it if you already have the frequencies ng carrier and ng sideband. So pwede nating sabihin na si upper sideband, si 557.5 kilo is equal na kay FC, which is 545 kilo minus FM. So we can now solve for FM. So using your calculator, 545 kilo minus 55, or rather the other way around, no? Plus ito, plus because this is upper side, but no? So 557.5 is actually 545 plus FM. So 545 plus FM, therefore the FM is 557.5 minus 545 kilo. So that gives you a value of 12.5. So yung FM natin is 12.5. So we can now say that this FM is equal to 12.5 kilohertz. And tama naman, no? Tama, 12.5 kilohertz. So, dito pinakita na if we have the FM as this value here and FM also as this value here, this entire bandwidth can actually be solved. Diba? So, if you will solve for the bandwidth, we know that it's basically 2 times the FM. So, that will be your bandwidth, 2 times the FM. And if the FM is 12.5 times 2, that becomes 25 kilohertz. So, you don't need actually to memorize this equation, but It would be handy also if alam mo na ito kaagad, no? So not by memorizing but by knowing that it will always be the carrier plus the maximum modulating signal to the carrier minus the maximum modulating signal. So that would be the range of your entire AM bandwidth, no? So and that would be 2 times the FM, but not the FM na lower limit but the maximum modulating frequency dapat, no? So for AM broadcasting, it's not actually 6 kilohertz, no? So for AM broadcasting, meron ng allowance na binigayan. So it is understood to be 10 kilohertz standard na bandwidth for AM broadcast. But sa Pilipinas, we only use 9 kilohertz sa ating dito, no? Sa AM natin. Sa international standards, we have 10 kilohertz. Okay, so let's continue to the modulation index. In our discussion kanina pa lang, no? Sa equation, we know that the modulation index is equal to Vm over Vc. So now let's discuss what really is this modulation index. So modulation index is the term used to describe the amount of amplitude change in an AM waveform. So ibig sabihin, if before modulation, your AM waveform is not changing, like the carrier is not changing, then we could really say that the modulation index there is zero pa. In short, there is no amount of change. But if after modulation, initially your VC or carrier peak is 5 volts. After modulation, this 5 volt turns to become 10 volts. Then we can say na, what is the modulation index? So masasabi natin that the modulation index here is from 5 naging 10, that should be 100%. No? So that gives me a modulation index equal to 1. So yun yung ibig sabihin na. No? So 100% change means that is 1 na modulation index. A 0% change means 0 na modulation index. A 50% change, like galing sa 5 volts na carrier, after modulation, you gain a maximum amplitude of 7.5. Then that would be 2.5 na increase, no? And that would be 50% na modulation. So 2.5 is 50% of the 5, no? So that would be the modulation index. So 0.5 the modulation index means you have 50% increase. 1 modulation index means you have 100% increase. 0 modulation index means you don't have really an increase in your amplitude ng carrier, no? So this is also called the modulation factor or modulating coefficient or the degree of modulation. So sometimes, as sinabi ko a while ago, a 0.5 modulation index means a 50% increase on your amplitude. So if the modulation index na value is expressed as percentage, then this will be referred now as the percentage modulation or percent modulation. So basically, it's just the modulation index expressed as percentage. And these are the basic two formulas that we always use to determine the modulation index of AM. So this cannot be used as the modulation index in FM. So iba din yung modulation index ng FM. So this is only limited to be used for AM. So M is equal to Vm over Vc, or M is equal to Vmax minus Vmin, and Vmax plus Vmin. So this Vmax and Vmin values nito can only be seen on the modulated wave. Whereas ito, kahit wala pa yung modulated wave, if meron ka ng Vm and Vc na value, pwede mo nang mahanap kaagad yung modulation index. And para ma-appreciate nyo yan, let's have an example. No? Let's analyze a wave ng AM. So provided I have an FM here, a modulating signal frequency, and an FC here, I can see that this is the peak of my FM, which in this problem or analysis, it's given to be 4 volts, whereas dito, it's given to be 5 volts. So kahit yun lang yung bibigay sa akin, alam ko na yung modulation index kaagad. No? Why? Because I have a formula na modulation index is equal to Vm over Vc. So basically, I could just substitute directly here. No? The Vm is equal to 4 volts and the Vc is equal to 5 volts. No? Using our calculator, that should give you 0.8. No? So 4 divided by 5, that's 0.8. So we know now that the modulation index here is 0.8. Walang unit. No? So modulation index is unitless. That is automatic makuha ko na kahit wala pa akong modulated wave. Kahit bibigay lang sa akin yung Vm, bibigay lang sa akin yung Vc, I could directly get the modulation index. So it means that if these two will be mixed together, it would be expected that the modulated wave will reach 80% na modulation. So 5 will not go to 100 because that would be 100%. So it will only go up to 9 volts na, no? Maximum. So let's talk about this actual waveform as a modulated na. So because nga, we have also another formula for modulation index, pag modulated na yung waveform na i-analyze natin, which is Vmax minus Vmin, over Vmax plus Vmin. So itong value na yan. So this is 0.8. So we can also use this formula. But again, hindi mo magamit yung formula na to if yung binigay lang is Vm and Vc. No? So if Vm and Vc lang, so ito talaga yung formula na magagamit. But if Vmax and Vmin yung bibigay sa modulated wave, ito na yung formula na gagamitin natin. So this is now your modulated wave. And kung makikita nyo, the peaks of this modulated wave resembles the shape of your modulating signal. And if we will connect those dots, ito na yung tinatawag nating envelope. So the peak amplitude ng envelope natin should be referred as the Vmax, and the minimum value niyan is referred as the Vmin. So if we analyze natin to, no? So if this really is the information, no? If this envelope resembles information and nagsisimula tayo sa 0 at positive 5, then if this length right here, no? If the magnitude from this point to that point is 4 volts, then we can also say that the magnitude from this point to that point is also 4 volts, di ba? So kaya nga, if from this point is 5 volts, then we can say that the Vmax is actually equal to 9 volts. So alam natin 9 volts yan. Huh? So again, if this is the zero line of your modulating signal, from this point is also 4 volts, di ba? So in short, from here to here is also 4 volts. So if this is 5 volts and that is 4 volts, then we know that this part right here is equal to 1 volt. So these are now the limits natin. No? The maximum voltage now is 9 volts and the minimum voltage now is 1 volt. So by knowing the maximum voltage and by knowing the minimum voltage, we can now solve for the modulation index. So the modulation index now is equal to Vmax, which is 9 volts, minus the Vmin, which is 1 volt, divided by the Vmax, which is 9 volts, plus 1 volt. So let's look at the answer now. This is actually equal to 8 over 10. So 8 over 10 is obviously 0.8. So hindi pa rin nagbago, no? So 0.8, 0.8. Tama pa rin, no? So regardless of ito ba yung formula ang gagamitin natin or ito yung formula ang gagamitin natin, wala namang nagbago sa ating modulation index. It really depends kung ano yung binigay sa problem, no? So if the Vmax and Vmin yung binigay, wala tayong choice. Ito talaga yung gagamitin natin, no? But if Vm over Vc yung, or Vm and Vc yung binigay, wala namang problema. Meron naman tayong formula also for that. So importante lang is alam natin saan hahanapin yung Vmax, saan hahanapin yung Vmin, just in case pagdating ng exam or board exam, hindi Vm, Vc diretso yung ibibigay, but waveform yung ibibigay. And you need to analyze the wave ng AMO. So looking at this one, we know that the modulation index is hindi umabot ng 1, no? So it's just 0.8. And if we will summarize, the waveform natin is ganito lang. So can you imagine if the modulation index is 1? So if the modulation index is 1, and this will reach up to 5, and this will also be 5, then it would really hit at 0. No? So ibig sabihin, by looking only at the waveform, we can really identify whether the modulation index is 0, modulation index is 1, or maybe less than 1, or maybe greater than 1. No? So if your modulated signal looks like this, then we know that this is exactly Vm equal to Vc. No? So ibig sabihin, yung Vm mo, nandito, ayan, no? So it could be seen as this. Ito yung Vm mo, and ito yung Vc mo, no? In which equal sila. Kaya nga, if this is the Vc, and this is the Vm, it really hits 0. So, and we know that when Vm is equal to Vc, Vm over Vc is equal to each other, then your modulation index will equal to 1. No? So Vm is equal to Vc, modulation index is equal to 1. So if this minimum value is not 1 volt, if this is at 0 volt, then we know that the modulation index there should be equal to not just 0.8, but 1. So I have prepared here waveforms ng amplitude modulated wave natin and determine what is the modulation index. So because dito, makikita natin, no, na ito yung value ng unmodulated, or this is the Vc, and this is the value of the Vm, Vm, and this obviously also is the value of the Vm. And if you've noticed, the Vc is equal to the Vm. So therefore, we know at this particular waveform that the modulation index is equal to 1. So how about dito? No? So if the envelope resembles your information, then we know that this is the value of Vm. But dito yung nagsisimula yung sakirye, no? So this is the value of Vc, in which kitang-kita mo naman, no? The Vc is greater than the Vm. So modulation index is equal to Vm over Vc. So if VC is greater than the VM, then we know that this will not be equal to 1 but lesser than 1. Oh, and it is obvious also because hindi siya umabot sa 0. So this is a modulation index which is less than 1. So hindi siya 100% modulation. Ito naman, alam natin, this is the information, this is the envelope of information, and this is now your VC, in which ito yung VM natin. So makikita natin na mas mahigit pa yung VM kaysa VC, and if the VM is greater than the VC, then this modulation index should obviously be greater than 1. Oh? So that would be now the modulation index greater than 1, and the bad thing nito is yung part na to will be cancelled by the parts ilalim, clipping of that area there. Oh? And this creates distortion. Why? Because when you recover this information, this envelope halimbawa, instead na ma-recover mo yung sine wave, yung ma-recover mo sa receiving side nito is a sine wave na na-clip na dito because of this part right here. So, and that is distortion na. No? So, kaya nga we don't recommend na yung M will be greater than 1 because it will introduce a distortion. And this M greater than 1 is actually referred also as over-modulation. And we know the effects of over-modulation in our previous discussion. No? It could actually create splatter or mga spurious emission. So this is not really advisable na mag-over-modulate. That's why kanina pa lang sinasabi ko parati na yung pinaka-maximum value lang dapat ng M is equal to 1, not greater than 1. Because if you exceed greater than 1, that would result over-modulation and distortion na inyong signal. So a carrier that looks like this simply means that your modulation index is zero. So walang pagbabago sa amplitude means zero yung modulation index mo, and that would be here. So ngayon na by looking at the figures, we can now analyze kung ano yung modulation index. Then the next step is to create the trapezoidal pattern on these particular waveforms. Now to create trapezoidal pattern, what you really need to do lang is to put a point on your max Vmax and your Vmins, then after that you draw straight line connecting every point. So for example, dito sa modulation index equal to 1, gagawa tayo ng trapezoidal pattern. We just need to get the point of your Vmax, mirror niya, and your Vmin. Then after that, you just simply connect it with a straight line. Yun yung kanyang trapezoidal pattern. So if it looks like a triangle lang, it means modulation index is equal to 1. So dito sa less than 1, we'll just put some points on your maximum minimum, then we just all connect them into a straight line. So that becomes now my trapezoidal pattern for modulation index less than 1. So dito naman, I have my max, max, and mean, no? So then I will connect it with straight line. So that now becomes my over-modulation trapezoidal pattern. Dito, max lang tayo, walang mean. So we can just simply put a bar like that. So that will now become my trapezoidal pattern for no modulation at all. So ang dali lang. So kung alam mo yung paggawa ng trapezoidal pattern, then obviously bibigyan ng problems board exam na trapezoidal pattern, masasagot mo rin yan. So meron din tayong mga exercise problems ng trapezoidal pattern doon sa inyong kukontest para mas higher pa yung maintindihan nyo dito. Okay, so now let's move on to the power, voltage, and current distribution and transmission in AM broadcasting. So, or AM amplitude modulation. So let's begin with the power. Now, ito yung re-recommend natin na kailangan nyong ma-memorize, no? Yung distribution of power ng tinatawag nating standard AM or double sideband full carrier. So, dalawang sideband, sideband 1, sideband 2, and isang carrier. So we need to know what are the powers dito sa spectrum na to. No? So the carrier obviously has the PC, and the upper and lower sideband has identical amount of power equivalent to PC M squared over 4. So you need to know this one. You need to really know this one. No? Kailangang maiguhit mo ito and masupply mo yung mga values na yan para hindi ka malilito later. No? So PC, PC M squared over 2, over 4 rather, PC M squared over 4. Now, for double sideband full carrier, you will be transmitting dalawang sideband and isang carrier. So that is obviously equal to PC plus power lower sideband plus power upper sideband, or power sideband lower, power sideband upper. So the total power of the sidebands and the carrier will be your transmitted power, and meron pa yung ready-made formula for that. The PT equal to PC plus or times 1 plus M squared over 2. But I don't really recommend na i-memorize mo lang yan without knowing kung saan galing yan. No? So, might as well know where this equation came from. So actually, this is coming galing lang dito sa PT na to. No? So we could simplify it as PT is equal to PC plus the power of sideband na lower, which is base ating equation, is equal to PC m squared over 4. So I could write here PC m squared over 4. This is for the lower, and another PC m squared over 4, that is for the upper. So because every term has a PC, I could factor out PC, and that gives me 1 plus PC. Wala nang PC kasi pinactor out na natin. So this will become m squared over 4 plus m squared over 4. Now we know that 1/4 plus 1/4 over 4 plus over 4 is over 2. So pwede kong sabihin PC times 1 plus m squared over 2. And that results to the same equation here for my PT. So actually you can derive. Pwede naman hanggang dito ka lang. Pwede na hindi mo na i-derive. Or you can derive also galing dito. What is really important is alam yung formula, and just in case makalimutan mo, there is a way na mahanap mo uli yan by knowing this diagram right here. No? Ito yung diagram dito. Now, this is only intended for single modulation na modulation index, but just in case your career is modulated by different information, pwede mo namang palitan ito ng total modulation index or the effective modulation index following this equation. So, this is to solve for the total modulation index or effective modulation index just in case your career is being modulated by several signals. So pwede natin gawin ito. No? So m1 squared plus m2 squared plus m3 squared square root, that would be our total modulation index. Okay, that's for the power ng standard AM or double sideband full career. Now let's move on to the voltage. Now if you have or if you will notice here, yung PC ginawa ko ng VC, and based on the equation kanina, alam natin that the maximum value of the lower sideband voltage is VCM over 2. No? Alam natin yan. No? Diniscuss natin yan kanina. And also the upper sideband voltage, VCM over 2. Walang square ha, VCM over 2. And that is not 4, it's just 2. So yun yung ating sideband voltage and career voltage. Now, to get the total voltage transmit at the transmitting output ng ating AM, we could use this equation. It's like parang nag-add ka lang ng mga square and square root, like, just like the modulation index effective. No? So V squared plus V squared plus V squared. So this is upper sideband and upper sideband, and this is upper sideband. Okay? So from here, I have a ready-made equation also. Pwede ko i-memorize ka agad yan, but pwede ko rin titingnan lang yung diagram na to, and knowing that to get the total voltage, that would be VC squared, V upper sideband squared plus V lower sideband squared square root. So pwede kong gawin yun. So I could say that VT is equal to the square root of the VC squared plus the upper sideband, let's say, VCM over 2 squared plus VCM over 2 squared ulit. So that would be my VT pa rin, no? From this equation here. No? So that is actually equal to VC squared plus VC squared m squared over 4. Plus VC squared m squared over 4. So because every term has a VC, pwede kong i-factor out yung VC. No? Square root of VC squared. So factor out natin yung VC squared. 1 plus m squared over 4 plus m squared over 4. So simplifying it, that becomes VC squared. 1 plus m squared 1/4 plus 1/4 is 1/2. So the square root of VC is actually, or VC squared is actually VC. Then square root of 1 plus m squared over 2. So again, that would be my VT reflected in this equation here. No? So pwede kong gamitin yan. No? So I could really use that also. As long as alam ko yung diagram na to. No? So my recommendation is you need to memorize the power diagram. Yung PC, tapos upper sideband is PC m squared over 4. Lower sideband PC m squared over 4 also. And this voltage diagram, because if you know this voltage diagram, it could also be applied to your current. So kung baka yung derivation na to, pwede mong palitan lang ng IT and IC, 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 it will still result to IT is equal to IC square root of 1 plus m squared over 2. And that would be the formula here. So no need to worry, wala kang i-memorize talaga dito. No? So as long as you have the diagram, it could really give you the backup just in case makalimutan mo yung mga formulas na to pagdating ng board exam. So I would recommend you familiarize and memorize the diagram. It could really help you. No? Lalo-lalo na sa iba't ibang configuration, kasi nga hindi lang naman double sideband full career yung AM. No? So we have different types of configuration that we will discuss along the way. Okay, so now let's move on to single sideband modulation.